Yeah, good afternoon and welcome to yet another online tutorial on microwaves and antennas. Right. So we are into module 3 and we have been discussing about radiation pattern and related space parameters of antenna. Right. So the topic yesterday we have seen how to visualize various radiation patterns. We have visualized cos square theta, cos 4 theta, cos 2 theta, cos theta, cos 2 theta and all those various radiation patterns we visualize. We also try to see what actually is meant by normalizing. So when I say normalize, it's you understood it's actually what dividing the given radiation pattern, whether it is a field pattern or power pattern, with its maximum value. Right. That was what we have seen yesterday. So today we'll see a completely different aspect. That is actually what a solid angle. But for you to appreciate the solid angle and the concept of antenna beam area, right, you should be comfortable with the antenna radiation pattern. But that's why we discussed that yesterday. So today we are going to discuss about this solid angle. So as the name suggests, right, it has got something to do with angle, but it's actually what, not actual angle, it's actually what, solid angle. So what is the solid angle? That is the question, right? So for that, we'll just recollect. Right, in two dimension, right, if you have a circle and if you consider an arc of length C, right, if you consider an arc of length C, right, this in 2D angle theta is defined as, in 2D, right, angle theta is defined as arc length, right, divided by radius. I hope you remember this, right? So angle is equal to arc by radius. So theta here in 2D is actually what, theta is equal to C by R, and the unit of angle is either radian or degree, right? Right, angle can be represented either as radian or degree, right? So this is in 2D, right? This is in 2D, right? The angle subtended by an arc of length C, right, at the center of a circle of radius R is given by theta. And you know the complete circumference of a circle, the angle subtended by complete circumference of a circle, what is the angle subtended by complete circumference of a circle? This angle is equal to 2 pi radian or 360 degree. You know this, already we know this, right? So these are very simple things, right? And the complete arc length, that's why circumference of a circle is actually what, 2 pi times R, right? 2 pi times R. So circumferences of a circle is actually what, 2 pi times R. That is nothing but what, the angle times the radius. The complete angle subtended by arc length of a circle is 2 pi and radius is R. You already know this. And one more thing which I want you to recollect is, right, this 2 pi radian is, 2 pi radian, it is equal to actually what, 360 degree, or I can write pi radian is 180 degree. So you should also be familiar with how to convert degree to radian and radian to degree. I'm just telling about the angle, the concept of angle in two dimension, right? You all are familiar with this, but we are just recollecting, right? So please pay very close attention. So what will be one radian? One radian, right? So pi radian is 180 degree. This is the conversion I have, right? So one radian is actually what, I should divide both sides with pi. So one radian will be 180 by pi degree, 180 by pi degree. And similarly, one degree will be, so in order to get one degree, I should divide both sides with 180. So it will be pi by 180, sorry, radian, right? Pi by 180 radian. And circumference of a circle is 2 pi r, or complete angle, right, inscribed or subtended within a circle is 2 pi radian or 360 degree. All of you are familiar with this, right? All of you are familiar with this. Now, if you extend this concept of angle in two dimension to 3D, three dimension, right? If you can extend this idea to 3D, right, then we'll get the concept of solid angle, right? We'll get the concept of solid angle. So in 2D, angle is equal to arc by radius, C by R, right? So arc length divided by radius of circle. So similarly, circle in two dimension, it becomes actually what? If you consider all points which are equidistant from origin, that will become a sphere. So circle will become a sphere, right? Circle in 2D, it will become a sphere in 3D, right? And so then angle, so angle in 2D, it will become actually what? Solid angle in 3D. I'll tell you what is that solid angle, right? So before that, I want you to be like comfortable with this basic spherical coordinate system. So this is origin of a spherical coordinate system. You know, in spherical coordinate, a point can be represented using its r, theta and phi, right? R is the radial distance of point from origin. If you consider point P here, right, r will be radial distance of the point from origin. Theta is the angle which r makes with positive z-axis, and phi is this angle. You know all those steps. So this is theta and this is phi, and theta can range from 0 to pi, and phi can range from 0 to 2 pi. You have already studied this, right? You have already studied this, right? So now I just want to right, extend this idea of solid angle. So before I start discussing this, right, what I will do is I will tell you what a solid angle actually, right? So in 2D, angle is actually what? Arc length by radius, right? So if you see this diagram, right, angle inscribed by arc length C is given by arc length by radius, right? Arc length by radius. So similarly, solid angle, right? Solid angle in 3D, you may not have studied this before, but you might have heard when you speak about a cone and all, you might have spoke about actually what solid angle of a cone and all. So, right. So solid angle, it is defined as, right? So please write solid angle, right? Solid angle normally we'll represent using omega. Right, we'll represent the solid angle using omega, right? So solid angle is defined as, right, I will write area divided by radius square. So here on numerator it was arc length, right? So the unit was meter, right? And denominator also it was radius, the unit was meter, right? But here when you define solid angle, in numerator it is area, that is meter square, and denominator also it is actually what? Meter square. And unit of the solid angle, it is steradian or radian square or degree square. I'll just tell speak about the unit later. So this is how solid angle is defined, right? Solid angle, I know you may not have understood anything, but this is how it is defined, area divided by radius square, right? So now, if you see this, maybe we can see that GeoGebra simulation works, right? So if you see this, if you consider a circle, right, maybe I'll try to take a pen if possible. If pen is there, I'll take one. Otherwise, right, 1 second, let me... We don't have a pen in this. So in 3D calculator, I think we don't have a. Okay, fine, no problem. Right, so we don't have a pen, but I hope all of you can see my mouse pointer. Please acknowledge. Can you see my mouse pointer? Whatever I'm showing here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So what happens is on if you consider a sphere, right? So a circle in 2D becomes a sphere in 3D. If you consider a sphere, right, and if you consider some area on the surface of a sphere, right, some area on the surface of a sphere, right, and this area, right, it will subtend some solid angle at the center of the sphere. That is the idea. So whenever I say area is surface of a sphere or some say pattern in spherical coordinate. So area is area of some surface on in spherical coordinate, and solid angle will be subtended at this origin, right, by that area. That is the idea, right? So Now I'm showing a part of this circle here, a sphere here. Right. This is part of a circle, a sphere. Right. And you can see this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is z-axis. Right. Z-axis is theta equal to zero, and theta increases like this. Right. Theta increases in this direction. So xy plane is theta equal to 90 degree, and negative z-axis is theta equal to say 180 degree. So before I move ahead and discuss, I would like to know, how comfortable are you with the concept of spherical coordinates? I'm very sure, right, you have studied this in electromagnetic waves, and I'm even more sure that Mahesh sir might have taught you it very wonderfully, right? So even then, I'm asking, how comfortable are you? When I say r theta phi, right, and when I say differential length along change in theta, differential length along change in phi, how comfortable you people are? Please do type it. Right, I want response from everyone. Right, depending upon that only I'll be able to proceed. On a scale of say 1 to 10, how familiar are you with the terms differential length, differential area, and all those stuff in spherical coordinates? Please, everyone, please respond. Right. Okay, 7 would be more than sufficient. Right, that is more than sufficient. Right. So when I say, you will be able to appreciate. Right. So that would be more than sufficient. Right. I know you people are being modest. It will be more than 7. Right. But to be on safer side, you might have told 7. Right. I raised my hand. Right. Okay. I didn't know. Right. By mistake, I raised my hand. Right. Yeah, I have a doubt. My doubt was this: on a scale of 1 to 10, how comfortable are you with the concept of spherical coordinates? Right. And right. So I 7. That's a very decent number for me to continue. So which means I don't have to discuss anything further. So you know, right. So if you consider a radial vector r, right. So if this point is r theta phi, the radial distance is actually what r. This is r, and this angle measured from positive z-axis is theta. And the projection, if you project this r onto xy plane, that projection will make an angle with positive x-axis, that is phi. You all are comfortable with that, right? So, and x positive x-axis is phi equal to 0, right? Positive y-axis is phi equal to 90 degree, right? Negative x-axis is phi equal to 180, negative y is 270, so on and so forth. And similarly, positive z is actually what? Theta equal to 0, and as you move downwards, right, towards negative z, theta will vary from 0 to pi. You all know that, right? And you know, if I consider a very small area on surface of a sphere, so this is that very small area on surface of a sphere, right? So you can see over a sphere, r is a constant. What will be changing? Theta will be changing in this particular direction. Maybe I should take some other color, right? Theta will be changing in this direction. Maybe I should zoom it in a bit. Right, I'll zoom it in a bit. Right, so that you'll be able to see it better. Right, so you know, theta is changing in this particular direction. Right, so like this, theta is changing, and a differential length along change in theta is r d theta. Right, so this angle is d theta. Right, and a small change in length, arc length corresponding to angle d theta is r d theta. That is according to what we have studied here. Angle is equal to arc by radius. So radius is r and angle is d theta. So arc length should be r d theta. So I think all of you are able to appreciate that. And similarly, phi changes in this direction. Phi changes in this direction. And a very small change in length along change in phi, that is nothing but what? R sine theta d phi. Right. R sine theta d phi. Right. So why? Because this is r, right? This this distance is r, and this angle is theta. So this one will be actually what? R sine theta. These two will be r sine theta. So r sine theta, and this angle is actually what? D phi. So you know, that is why it is r sine theta d phi. I don't have to teach you that. But again, right? So if you consider a very small area on surface of a sphere, that is a differential area on surface of a sphere. The sides, the differential lengths are actually what, which defines the square area, it is actually what, square or a rectangular area, it is r d theta and r sine theta d phi, right? And so the area, this area can be written as actually what, it is r d theta into r sine theta d phi, that is r square sine theta d theta d phi, right? That is r square sine theta d theta d phi. So all of you are comfortable with that? Whether all of you are comfortable with that? Chavan, I hope, right, maybe I'll
take, yes, sir.
Right, all of you may be knowing this, right? I don't have to struggle much to, right. So now, next, right, these things you already know, I suppose. So now what I'm going to do is, we want to find out, right, so I defined solid angle like this. Solid angle is actually what? It is a three-dimensional counterpart of angle, right? So when you consider an arc length in 2D, it will subtend an angle in 2D, right? And similarly, when you consider a small area on a sphere in 3D, you can see it will subtend a solid angle at the center of a sphere, which will actually what, involve change in theta and change in phi, right? So which will involve change in theta and change in phi. So there are actually what, two orthogonal angles which are changing, theta and phi. So it will, that is actually called actually solid angle, right? For instance, a cone, right? If you consider cone, right, it has a solid angle inscribed within it, right? The angle of the cone, that is actually a solid angle. Why? Because it's not a 2D angle, it's a 3D angle, right? So that is why it's a solid angle, right? So if you consider an area, it will subtend a solid angle at the center of a sphere. That is the idea, right? Any area, right? So now what we are going to find is, I'm going to find solid angle subtended by differential area. I'll write differential area as dA at the center of a sphere of radius r. This is what we have to find out, right? So this is the definition of solid angle, right? So maybe solid angle subtended by the differential area, that is what we have to find. So the definition of solid angle is area by radius square. So radius is r, right? And area is actually what, dA, right? So I am going to write it as, right, as it is differential solid angle, so I'll write it as d omega. Why? Because it is solid angle subtended by differential area. So it is d omega. This will be equal to dA divided by r square. This is as per the definition, right? dA divided by r square. And this dA will be actually what? It is r d theta times r sine theta d phi divided by r square. So this is equal to actually what? R square and r. So it is, this is nothing but what? R square sine theta d phi divided by r square. What happens? This r square and r square gets cancelled. So I will get now d omega, right? I will get d omega is equal to sine theta d phi. So this is actually what? Differential solid angle subtended by a differential area, right? And unit of solid angle is, it is steradian, also represented as SR, right? Or it can be radian square. It can be radian square. Why? Because it involves two angles, d theta and d phi, right? So it's actually what, multiplication of two angles, right? So that is why it's actually what, solid angle, or the unit is square radian, or it can also be actually what, degree square. Degree square, right? It can also be degree square. Are you okay with this, what we have done now? What I have done is simple, right? I defined what a solid angle. Solid angle is actually what, extension of two-dimensional plane angle into 3D, right? Solid angle, it is 3D, right? It is defined as area by radius square. on surface of a sphere or surface of any 3D surface, it will, if you say join the boundaries of that surface to origin, right? Any, it can be, it need not be on a sphere itself, right? If you join, right, if you, suppose you have this coordinate system, right, suppose you have some irregular area, right, like this, if you join the boundaries of this irregular area to the sender or origin, right, so it will define a solid angle, right? It need not be on surface of a sphere itself, right? So any area in three dimension will define a solid angle at origin. So that solid angle is given by, right, area by square of radius, right? So if it is a sphere, right, radius is a constant. If it is an irregular shape, then we'll have to go for some other, actually what we'll have to divide it into very small areas and find the differential areas of each, right, and the differential solid angles we'll have to sum up, like that we'll have to do, right? But okay, fine. So is this clear? Is this concept clear? Maybe please do type in what we have done. I defined, now what we have done is, right, I defined solid angle, then I found out what is the solid angle subtended by a differential area at the center of a sphere, right? So this is d omega, and I also told the unit of solid angle is radian or radian square and degree square, right? And you know now why it is radian square or degree square. Why? Because it involves changing two angles, d theta and d phi, two angles which are mutually orthogonal are changing, right? So that is actually what solid subtended by solid angle subtended by differential area at the center of a sphere. Next, I want to find out what is the solid angle subtended by a solid angle the total solid angle subtended by a sphere of radius r, right, at its center, spelling centre or center. Can anyone help me out? I always used to have confusion, right? Now I think I should, right, what is the spelling of center? Right, CNTER or CNTRE? Please, anyone help me out? I always used to have confusion. It's CNTRE, so I'll use CNTRE. Thank you, Suvira. Right, it's center. Right, right. So that is what you have to find. So maybe I'll call it as actually what omega. Right, omega. Right, omega is what I'll call it. Right. So now we'll see a sphere once again, right? I know you all know what is a sphere, but again, right? So we have a sphere, right? So a sphere has a total surface area. Oh, sorry. What is the total surface area of a sphere? It will be 4 pi r square, or else if I, right, so integrate, right, a differential area on a sphere over the sphere, right, I will get total surface area. For that, I'll write omega is equal to, right, I will write omega is equal to area of sphere divided by r square. And all of you know area of sphere is actually what, 4 pi r square. But to make it a bit complicated, what I can write is, this is given by integrating theta from 0 to pi, right, pi from 0 to 2 pi, right, this dA, right, if you integrate this dA from theta from 0 to pi and pi from 0 to 2 pi, that will be area of a sphere, that divided by r square. So that is actually what, integral theta from 0 to pi, pi from 0 to 2 pi, it is nothing but what, r square sine theta d phi divided by r square. And if you integrate this, for sure you will get 4 pi r square, right? I don't want to teach you how to integrate this, right? First you integrate with respect to phi, you will get 2 pi. Then if you integrate sine theta, right, right, sine theta d theta from 0 to 2 pi, you will get again another actually what, 2, right, then it will be 4 pi r square. You know how to do that, so I'm not doing that, right. So this omega is equal to, we will get 4 pi r square divided by r square. So this is equal to 4 pi steradian. So this is another very, very important result which we have, right. Solid angle of a sphere, right, it is 4 pi r square by r square, it is 4 pi steradian, right. Solid angle of a sphere is 4 pi steradian, right. So initially we found out d omega, right, initially we found out d omega, right, or else in other words I can tell, right, what we have a solid angle is actually what, solid angle is equal to area by r square, right, or I can write area is equal to actually what, area is equal to r square d omega, right, area is equal to r square d omega, right. So total area of a sphere, if you integrate this r square d omega, right, or r square times omega, r square times omega, right. So this is also possible, like this also I can tell, but right, this is another way, right. So I can't discuss all actually what aspects in this class, right. So this is again another way. So did you understand, the total solid angle of a sphere is 4 pi steradian, right. So or area of a sphere would have been r square times omega, right. Area of a sphere is r square times, right, area of a sphere is r square times omega. So this omega is 4 pi, like that also you can write. So same thing we have done, but mathematically that's it, right. So it's 4 pi steradian. So that is another thing, right. So now I introduce you to what is solid angle. We have seen what is d omega. So I'll write the result. What was d omega? Can anyone tell me? D omega, it is the solid angle subtended by a differential area on a sphere, that was sine theta, d phi, right. And so that was d omega. And omega of a sphere is actually what, 4 pi steradian. So you should remember these two results, right. These two results you should remember, right. Now I want you to convert between steradian, right, this is equal to actually what, radian square. Steradian, that is equal to radian square. How to convert it into degree square? How to convert steradian into degree square? That is the next thing I am going to discuss, right. So one steradian is equal to one radian square, that is actually what, one radian times one radian, and one radian, you know, one radian is 180 by pi degree, right. So it will be equal to 180 by pi degree into 180 by pi degree. So this is equal to actually what, 180 by pi the whole square, right. And square degrees normally we can write as actually what, write as a square, right. Like this we can write square degree, right. It is nothing but square degree. If you see somewhere like this, right, it is actually called square degree, right. So can anyone tell me what is this 180 by pi in number? So I'll write one steradian is equal to how many square degrees? 180 by pi, what is the value of 180 by pi? Anyone has calculator, please calculate.
57.2957.
So 180 by pi the whole square, it is
3282.80.
I'll write approximately equal to 3283 square degree. So this is a very important conversion, right. One steradian is, right, degree square can also be represented as actually what, like this, right. So one steradian is 3283 square degree. So this is very, very important result. Please keep in mind, right. One steradian is 3283 square degree, right. Now we will see what will be 4 pi steradian, right. Solid angle of a sphere, right, 4 pi steradian in square degrees. So 4 pi steradian in square degrees it will be 4 pi into 180 by pi the whole square, and this is approximately equal to, can anyone tell me what is this? This much square degrees, right? So when I write like this, it means square degrees, right? What is this 4 pi into 3283?
41,252.96
approximately it is equal to 41,253 square degrees. So 4 pi radian or total solid angle of a sphere in square degrees is 41,253 square degree, right? So this is what I just wanted, right? So these are the results. So now what and all we have seen, we'll just go up and see. I have defined what is a solid angle, that is area by radius square. It need not be on a sphere of or area on a sphere. It can be any area in spherical coordinate, right? It will subtend a solid angle at the center, that is given by area divided by radius square, right? Area divided by radius square, right? And the unit is radian or radian square or degree square, right? And then we found solid angle subtended by a differential area at the center of sphere of radius r is d omega, that is sine theta d theta d phi steradian, this much steradian, right? Then we extended it to total solid angle of a sphere. Total solid angle of a sphere is 4 pi steradian, right? Then what we did is we found the conversion. Right, steradian to, right, conversion, steradian or radian square to square degree conversion. That is what we have seen next. Right, is it clear? Any doubt in this, please feel free to ask. I'll give 1 minute. Right, I'll give 1 minute time. Any doubt in the topics discussed so far, please feel free to ask. Any doubt? Is it clear? What we have discussed, only very few points. Right, nothing complicated. Right, don't think there is something complicated in it. Right, is it okay? Are you okay with this? These concepts which you have discussed.
Yes.
Please type yes or no, all of you. So, okay. I need someone else other than Savan to respond. Right. It's okay. Right. Yeah. Please. Okay, yeah, okay, CR himself have come to rescue of everyone else, right? Okay, so fine, then I'll move ahead, right? Then I'll move ahead. So these things we have seen, right? These things we have seen, right? Now, again, we'll go back to our GeoGebra, right? Again, we'll go back to our GeoGebra, right? So you can see this is a unit sphere, right? This is a unit sphere. Unit sphere means a sphere of radius 1 meter or 1 unit, right? And the total surface area of the sphere will be 4 pi into 1 square, right? Total surface area of a unit sphere will be 4 pi into 1 square, that will be 4 pi meter square, right? So this 4 pi meter square subscribes 4 pi steradian at center, right? 4 pi meter square defines 4 pi steradian at center. So I can define one steradian now, right? So I can define one steradian can be defined, right? Now this is again very, very important, can be defined as the solid angle subtended by 1 meter square area at, okay, 1 meter square area right at center of a sphere of radius 1 meter, right? A sphere of radius 1 meter, right? This is actually one steradian. Why? Because if you consider a sphere of radius 1 meter, the area will be 4π into 1 square, that is 4π, and the solid angle is area divided by r square, so that will be 4π divided by 1, so that 4π steradian. So 4π meter square area defines for a unit sphere. Okay, it's for a unit sphere. If radius of this sphere changes, right, this changes, right? So unit sphere, 4π meter square defines a solid angle of 4π steradian. So 1 meter square will define a solid angle of 1 steradian. So in general, for any sphere of radius r, right, 1 steradian is actually what? 1 steradian will be angle subtended by dash meter square area on sphere at center. What is the answer to this? If you consider sphere of radius r, right, the surface area will be 4π r square, and this 4π r square will define a solid angle of 4π steradian, right? So then 1 steradian will correspond to how much area on surface of a sphere of radius r? That is the question, right? I need everyone to type it in chat window. Please do type it in chat window, right? I hope you understood my question, right? If you have a sphere of radius r, right, what area of the sphere will subtend the area of 1 steradian at the center? That is the question, right? I'll give you options, and don't worry, I'll give options, right? The options are 1 meter square, 4π meter square, r meter square, r square meter square. Which is the answer? A, B, C, D. Right. What is the answer to this question which I asked? Please type in, right, A, B, C, or D. You can take wild guess, no problem. Right, Savan, you told what is correct. It's correct. It's r square. Right, the r square is correct answer. I want everyone to just think through that, why it is r square. Right, so it's an area of r square on the sphere will subtend a 1 steradian at center. So that 4π times r square will subtend 4π steradian. As simple as that. Right. So now again we'll go back and see our this. Radiation pattern, right? Again, we have to, right? So next topic is actually what? Next topic is, before I go ahead with this, next topic is, right, antenna beam area, right? So, and I'll tell antenna beam area or beam solid angle, it is the integral of normalized power pattern over a sphere. That is actually what? Pi from 0 to 2 pi, theta from 0 to pi, p and theta pi d omega, where d omega is the differential solid angle, right? So before I discuss with this, I want you to be actually what? Once again, right, we'll just quickly go to GeoGebra and once again see what was actually this normalized power pattern or whatever, right? So for instance, right, suppose you have a pattern, right? Suppose you have a pattern, 3 times... cos power 4 theta, right? The pattern 3 times cos power 4 theta, right? It will be like this. I'll just zoom to quick. What happened? It got stuck. Excuse me. like it got stuck, I guess. Like, excuse me for a moment. Okay, yeah, sorry, I didn't. Right, so the pattern 3 times cos power 4 theta, it looks like this. And you can see the maximum value of this is actually what? 3. Maximum value of radiation happens along positive z-axis, and that is equal to 3 units. If it is power pattern, right, the maximum power radiated is 3 units. If it is field pattern, the maximum field intensity is 3 units. Right. So what is meant by normalizing this? Right. So before that, I'll show you a unit sphere. Right. I'll show you a unit sphere. Right. You can see a unit sphere here, a sphere of radius 1 unit. Right. You can see a unit sphere. So now just see this bigger one is actually what the pattern 3 cos power 4t. Now if I normalize this, when I am normalizing, what I should do? I should divide it with maximum value. That is, I should divide it with 3. So when I normalize that, just see what happens. All of you please see very carefully. Jim boom ba. What is happening? So when I, right. What happened now? Can anyone tell me what happened? Right. When I, right, utter that actually what? Magic sound. Jim boomba. Right. It got normalized and the pattern got fit into this unit sphere. Did you see that? All of you notice that? Yes or no? Right. All of, right. So, what actually is meant by normalizing? Normalizing means, right, making the maximum value to 1. So, now I'll just, instead of this cos power 4t, right, I will take some other pattern. Say, I'll take 5 times, say, cos t into, say, cos 5t, right. 5 times cos t into cos 5t. That pattern I'll consider. So, I'll have to zoom to fit. Right. So, this is again another radiation pattern. You can see, right, it has a main beam along positive z and it radiates somewhat in this direction, maybe around plus 60, theta equal to 30 degree, theta equal to 60 degree, theta equal to 120, then again 150, then, right. So, this is the radiation pattern. So, when you normalize this, what is supposed to happen? Right. So, on behalf of me, I would request Savan or someone to tell Jim Boomba. So, let's see what happens. Right. So, when I'm normalizing it, you can see it's getting fit into a unit sphere. Right. It's getting fit into a unit sphere. Right. So, this is what is happening. Right. So, now, my question is, what is the solid angle subtended by a complete sphere? It is 4 pi steradian. Right. So, similarly, I can define the solid angle subtended by any other pattern. Right. That pattern can be what a humongous whale, right, which is stringed into a unit sphere, or it can be an African elephant stringed into a unit sphere, or it can be a small amoeba, right, normalized, right. Whatever it is, right, the solid angle of any other shape other than a sphere will be less than 4 pi steradian. Right. That is something which I wanted to tell, but I know you are not yet ready to appreciate that. But before I tell that, so I hope you are ready with, you are okay with the concept of aspect of normalizing. Right. So when you normalize, what happens? The entire pattern, the shape is retained, but it is getting fit into a unit sphere so that the maximum value will be equal to unity. Right, and all other value will be less than unity. Right, that is what is meant by normalizing. So, any pattern you take, whether the pattern is, whatever be the shape of the pattern, right, the pattern can be of the form of a tree or whatever. Right, so if you normalize it, that will fit into a unit sphere. And the, farthermost point on the tree, which from the origin, will be actually what of length 1 unit, right? So that is actually meant by normalizing, right? Now, why are we interested with the sphere? Why are we so interested with the sphere? That is another question. So sphere. So did I tell you about what is an isotropic radiator? Did I tell you what is an isotropic radiator? Did I tell what is an isotropic radiator?
Yes, sir.
What is an isotropic radiator, Savan?
That will radiate equally in all directions.
Equally in all directions. Suppose if I keep the source and origin, right? So if I give some power, it will radiate in all directions. So it will spread the power equally in all directions. It will spread the power actually what? Across in all directions. Right. So that is an isotropic radiator. Right. So the radiation pattern of an isotropic radiator, right? The normalized pattern will be one, or else, right? If the power density at some distance r, if it is 3 units, right? If power density at some distance r is 3 units, right? You can see, right? So this will be the radiation pattern of an isotropic radiator, which means an isotropic radiator radiates equally in all directions, right? Equally in all directions. So the radiation pattern is a sphere, right? And if you normalize it, what you will get? So you know. Right. If you normalize, it should shrink to a unit sphere. Right. So when I divide it with 3, it actually what shrink to a unit sphere. So again, it radiates in all 4 pi steradian. It radiates equally in all 4 pi in all direction in all. sorry, all theta and phi it is radiating. Right. So I can tell the beam area of an isotropic radiator is 4 pi steradian, right? So what actually is beam area of an isotropic radiator? It is 4 pi steradian, right? If you take any other pattern other than actually an isotropic radiator, right? If you take, can you tell any other pattern, a function of theta? Say, I'll write, maybe it can be cos power or cos 5 theta, right? Cos 5 theta, I'll write simply any pattern you take for the matter of fact, right? It will be, right? Cos 5 theta, I should be typing, right? I should be typing cos 5 theta, right? But oh, so it should not be theta, it should have been t, sorry, right? I should be typing cos 5t. You can see this is that pattern, cos 5t. Right. So it is not radiating equally well in all direction. You can see it's radiating in this particular direction, but in most other direction it's not radiating. Further, it is radiating in this direction, and some more like in another lobe it is radiating. Right. It's not radiating in all directions. So if you see beam area of any other radiator, right, would be less than an isotropic radiator. The coverage you can tell, right? The spatial coverage, beam area, it is a spatial footprint or spatial coverage of an antenna. Right. So the maximum spatial coverage will be there for an isotropic radiator. If it is an isotropic radiator, you will get good coverage in all directions. Right. But in most of the time, we don't want an isotropic radiator. Right. We will have a transmitter at some point and receiver at some point. Right. The transmitter can be a satellite and receiver will be some, say, a DTH dish at our home. Right. So we don't want to receive from all the satellites. We want to receive from a particular satellite, which provides us direct video broadcast, right? Direct TV broadcast. So it's simply waste of power, right? If you transmit it in all directions. So we have to just focus it, right? So if it is an Indian satellite, its footprint should fall only in India, right? Pakistan should not get any benefit, right? Or the nearby Sri Lanka should not get any benefit, right? And similarly, if it is a Pakistan satellite, right, the footprint should be available only to Pakistan, right? It need not transmit to actually what India. So we are not interested in broadcasting. In some cases, actually what we may need global coverage, but for most of the specific applications, we don't want global coverage. So we want the power to be focused in some direction. So that's why if you give 1 watt power to an isotropic radiator, it will spread that 1 watt into all directions, right? So everyone will get only little bit. Right. Even the intended user only will get little bit. But if you use a highly directional antenna, right, so you can make the entire power focused, right, entire power concentrated in a particular direction. So the power density received at that point will be more. I discuss this aspect when I discuss the types of antenna, right? So why do we need to go for this parabolic reflector and all, right? So that aspect I discussed. So similarly, any other antenna will have less beam area. So with this idea, we'll go on and discuss what is beam area or beam solid angle of an antenna, right? We'll go on and discuss what is beam area or beam solid angle of an antenna, right? So beam area of an antenna, right? It is integral of normalized power pattern over a sphere, right? For instance, if you assume it is an isotropic radiator, normalized power pattern value will be actually what? 1. And if you integrate d omega into 1 over theta from 0, sorry, theta from 0 to pi and pi from 0 to 2 pi, you will get 4 pi, right? That is the maximum you will get, right? If it is any other pattern, instead of 1, if it is cos square theta or cos theta or an elephant, right, which is normalized, or an humongous whale, which is normalized to a unit circle, right, it cannot subtend as much solid angle as a sphere at its center, right? That is the idea. So beam area is the coverage, right? The coverage, the spatial coverage an antenna gives, right? So mathematically, you can find it out as actually what omega A is equal to integral of normalized power pattern times d omega, right? So should we stop it here, or can I take 5 minutes extra? Should we solve one problem? It's up to you. If you want, we can stop it here, or else I'll solve one problem. Everyone, right? Is it okay? I'll take hardly 5 minutes extra. Would that be fine? Anyway, we started, I think now, anyway, it's only 15 minutes class, right? So I should, if I solve a problem, then it will make more sense, right? So now itself, if we can solve, right, you are in touch with this equation now, right? So that is what is actually what beam area or beam solid angle, right, of an antenna. So it can be any pattern. So for instance, the pattern can be, right, once again, I'll just go to, right, this pattern can be cos power 4 theta, right? So suppose the pattern is cos power 4 theta. Right, suppose the pattern is cos power 4 theta. You can see this is how the pattern will look like, right, cos power 4 theta. And you can see it radiates along positive z and negative z, right? So the total angle subtended, the coverage, spatial coverage is less than 4 pi c radian for sure. We need to find out what is the total coverage. For that, right, if it was a sphere, everywhere the normalized power pattern value would have been 1, right? Everywhere the normalized power pattern value would have been 1 if it is a isotropic radiator or a sphere. But now, what is the value of normalized power pattern? It is a function of theta. That is actually what? Cos square theta, right? So, or the position, any point on this, right? Any point on this radiation pattern, right? It is nothing but what? It is a position vector, right? Someone is trying to join in, I think, right? Any point on this radiation pattern will be a position vector, right? You know what is a position vector? Position vector is actually what? A vector joining origin and the point, right? So any point will be a position vector. It will have coordinates r, theta, and phi, right? So fortunately, right, that position vector, it's a function of only theta, right? The magnitude of position vector is actually what? Cos power 4 theta. It's function of only theta, right? So you can see here it is maximum. As you move, it is varying as a function of theta. So the normalized power pattern is cos power 4 theta. Right now, this equation says I can find the total beam area by integrating normalized power pattern with respect to d omega. So we'll try to do that. We'll try to do that. Right. We'll try and find out what is that. Right. So I told omega A is equal to integral theta from 0 to pi, pi from 0 to 2 pi, Pn theta phi d omega. So this is actually what the equation for beam area of an antenna, beam solid angle of an antenna. Right. Beam area of an antenna. It is the equation, right? Mathematically. And physically, you know what is beam area. It is the coverage, right? Coverage in terms of solid angle, right? Beam area. When I say area, it's not in meter square. We'll be telling it's beam solid angle, right? Beam area it is same as beam solid angle. Right. So first we will find omega A of an isotropic radiator. Isotropic radiator. We need to find omega of an isotropic radiator. You know, for an isotropic radiator, P and theta comma phi, right? The radiation pattern of an isotropic radiator is actually what? It's a sphere, right? It's a sphere. The normalized power pattern is 1, right? P and theta phi is equal to 1. So omega A, I think someone else again is trying to join in. I'll just accept. Right. So omega A is equal to integral theta from 0 to pi, pi from 0 to 2 pi, p n theta comma phi d omega, right? Where this d omega, what was this d omega? It was nothing but what? Sin theta, d phi. We already know that. We already defined it. That's why initially itself we defined that, right? So now this is equal to integral theta from 0 to pi, integral pi from 0 to 2 pi, 1 into sine theta, d phi, right? So if you integrate this, what is that you will get? Can anyone help me out to integrate this? So integral theta from 0 to pi, sine theta, times integral pi from 0 to 2 pi, d phi. So this integral will be integral 0 to 2 pi d phi will be 2 pi, and integral sine theta d theta from 0 to pi will be 2. Right? You can try it out. Right? You have already done this many times. Right? So integral 0 to pi sine theta d theta will be 2, and integral 0 to pi from 0 to 2 pi d phi is 2 pi. As d theta and d phi are mutually separable or orthogonal, I can actually what simultaneously integrate and multiply, or else first you integrate with respect to pi, then you integrate with respect to theta, right? Or the other way around. Anything would be fine, right? So this will be equal to 4 pi steradian, right? So omega A for a isotropic radiator is 4 pi steradian, right? So that is one very important result what we got, right? Someone else is again trying to join in, right? Right. If someone has to leave, please feel free to leave. What you can do is you can watch the video. I'll pause the video. Right. If someone has any other right commitments, right, can leave. Otherwise, please do stay back. Right. So now, is that clear? How did we find this solid angle of a beam solid angle of an isotropic radiator? Is it clear how to use this equation? Please respond. Right. Okay. I hope. So now from now on, I'll assume if you have any doubt, you will ask. Right. If you don't ask anything, I'll have to assume it's clear. Right. Please ask doubts if you have. Right. Anyway, fine. Right. So that is about a isotropic radiator. Right. So then second question, maybe the one which we shown here. If PN is equal to an antenna has a power pattern, normalized power pattern pn theta comma phi, right? They may not give pn. P theta comma phi is equal to cos power 4 theta, right? What is omega A? That is the question, right? A particular antenna has a pattern given by cos power 4 theta. What is omega A? So you know by definition, this is actually cos square 4 theta. Its maximum value is equal to 1. So it is a normalized pattern itself. So even if it is given as P of theta comma phi, you find it as considered as normalized. But if instead of this, it is given as 4 cos power 4 theta, what you should do, you should normalize it first, right? So now, omega A is equal to actually what? Integral theta from 0 to pi, phi from 0 to 2 pi, p n theta phi d omega. P n theta phi is equal to actually what? Cos power 4 theta. D omega is sine theta, d phi, right? So, this is equal to, right? I hope you know this, how to solve this integral, but you know, right? I is equal to integral theta from 0 to pi, pi from 0 to 2 pi, right? Cos power 4 theta times d omega is sin theta, d phi, right? So we have cos power 4 theta, sin theta, d theta as function of theta and only d phi, right? In terms of phi, right? So you can first integrate it with respect to phi. So you will get it, right? So maybe integral theta from 0 to pi, cos power 4 theta, sin theta, d phi, and integration with respect to integral phi from 0 to 2 pi, d phi, this will be equal to 2 pi. So you can write it as, right, you can write it as 2 pi into integral theta from 0 to pi, cos power 4 theta, sin theta, d theta. Right, 2 pi into cos power 4 theta, sin theta. So how to solve this integral? I know you may be knowing how to solve this integral. You can solve this integral using a substitution method. Or else, can you find the integral with the help of calculator? Can you find the integral with the help of calculator? Can you find it with the help of calculator? Shall we stop it here or should we finish this problem? Right. Maybe I can give it as a homework. You try this and come. Right. Try to solve this integral and come. Right. I'll give this as a homework. Right. Maybe in next class we'll finish it. Or if you're okay, but anyhow, I've taken 10 minutes extra. So I don't think it's fair to make you people wait. I should. Right. So someone has written, sir, you should start and end class on time. So I found that as a very valid point. Right. I should be a bit more systematic. I should learn how to start at time and end at time, right? So maybe I'll stop this here, right? I'll give this as homework, right? So please try to evaluate this. It's very simple, right? I'll give a hint, right? You have to make a substitution. Cos theta is equal to u or cos theta equal to x, right? Then we'll get minus sine theta d theta will be equal to du, and also limits will change. Theta from 0 to pi, limits of u will change. Limit also will change. Then you will get the answer. So please do solve it. Right. Please do solve it. That's it. Right. So that's it for today. Right. Yeah. All of you can leave. Right. So please do solve this problem. Is it right? So instead of this cos power 4 theta, it can be anything else. Right. So it's just actually about matter of integration. That's it. Right. Yeah. So all of you can leave. Thank you so much for joining.